those big guys only been here an hour. It doesn't say five. Sure, it's got mirrors and the big pants more, but I'll come if I'm the plot not cold before. Here at the First Baptist Bar and Grill, it's in the only church in the Bible Belt that smells like a whiskey still. Not a stained glass with anywhere in sight, just a bloodstained floor and neon lights, and the community wine here is always chill. Now we're here every Sunday with a living Lars, the only church with a covered church. And then you don't like our doctrine, then frankly and devout. Have a three white-haired octogenarian doctors throw your blasphemous backsliding butt out of the First Baptist Bar. By that gentleman right there at the bar. Here is Charlie Daniels on Easy Rider. I was taking a trip out to L.A., cruising along in my Chevrolet, singing out loud and digging on the radio. Just as I crossed the Mississippi line, I heard that highway starting to whine. I knew that left front tire was about to go. I got uptight because it wasn't a service station in sight, so I just slipped on down the shoulder on the rim. I went as far as I could, but when I stopped the car, it was right from this little bar, kind of a redneck-looking joint called the New Drop Inn. Well, I stuffed my hair up under my hat, and I told the bartender that I had a flat, but he'd be kind enough to give me change for a one. There's one thing I was sure glad to see. There was a soul in the place there for him and me. And he just looked disgusted and pointed toward the telephone. I called up the station down the road a ways, and he said he wasn't very busy today. He'd have somebody there just about 10 minutes or so. He said, "Hey, you just stay right where you're at." And I didn't bother to tell the darn fool that I sure as heck didn't have any place else to go. Bar, and some guy walked in and said, "Who owns that car with the pizza sign, mag wheels, and four on the floor?" Well, he glared at me, and there was nowhere to hide. I said, "That just better wait outside." I threw a fiver on the bar and headed for the door. Just when I thought I'd get out of there with my skin, these high-big dudes come stomping in with this one old drunk chick and some fellow with green teeth. And you tipped your hat to this lady's son, and when I did, all that hair fell out from underneath. Now the last thing I wanted was to get in a fight in Jackson, Mississippi on a Saturday night, especially when there's a bunch of them and there's only one of me. But they all started laughing, I felt kind of sick. I knew I'd better think of something pretty quick, so I just reached out and kicked old green jean right in the knee. Well, he let out a yell, curling your hair, but before he could move, I grabbed me in chairs and watching folks, because he's an early dangerous man. Well, you may not know, but this man's a spy. He's undercover agent for the FBI. He's been sent down here to infiltrate the Ku Klux Klan. Well, he's still bent over, holding on to his knee, but everybody else was looking and listening to me, and I laid it on thicker and heavier as I went. So would you believe this man has gone as far as tearing Trump stickers off the bumpers of cars? He voted for Hillary Clinton for president. Well, he's a friend of the long-haired hippie-type pinko saps. I bet you he's even got a commie map tacked up on the wall inside of his garage. He's stinking the grass, I tell you guys. He may look dumb, but that's just a disguise. He's a mastermind in the ways of espionage. They all started looking real suspicious, and he jumped up and said, "Now just wait a minute, Jim, you know he's lying. I've been living here all of my life. I'm a faithful follower of Brother John Roach, and I belong to the Antioch Baptist Church, and I've got a garage. You come home and ask my wife." Then he started saying something about the way I was dressed, and I didn't hear the rest. I was too busy moving and hope I didn't run out of luck. And when I hit the ground, I was making tracks. tracks. We were just taking my car down off the jack. So I threw the man a 50 and jumped in and fired that mother up. Dale Earnhardt Jr. would have sure been proud at the way I was moving when I passed that crowd coming out the door and headed toward me at the trot. And I guess I should have gone ahead and run, but somehow I just couldn't resist the fun of chasing the ball just once around the parking lot. Well, they headed for the trucks, but I hit the gas. I spun around, headed them off in the pass. I was slinging gravel and swirling some dust in the air. Yeah, I had them all out there stepping and pitching like their heads were on fire and their rear ends was catching, but I figured that they would slip before the cops got there. And when I hit the road, I was really wheeling, had gravel flying and rubber squealing. I didn't slow down while I was almost Arkansas. But I think I'm gonna reroute my trip. I wonder if anybody think I flipped. I went to L.A. via Omaha. Thank you. I'm Nicky Ryder by Kelly Daniels. Okay, let's see what else I've got on my list. I don't remember anymore, so I have to depend on my phone here. Johnny Cash tune. If my father had named me Sue and split, I think I might be a little bit more upset about it than Johnny Cash appeared to be when he sang my song. So here's my dramatized version of A Boy Named Sue. You know, my daddy left home when I was three. Didn't leave very much to Mama and me. Just his old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. And yeah, I blame him cause he run and hit. But the meanest thing my daddy ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought that it was quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs and lots of love. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Some gal was giggling, I turned red. Laughing, I'll bust his head and tell him, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. But I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fists got hard and my wits got keen. Roll from town to town to hide my shame. What it made me about is the moon and stars. I'd search the honky tonks and bars. Kill that man! Gatlinburg in mid-July, just in town, my throat was dry. Thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. Had no saloon on the street of mud. There was a table deep and stud. Such a dirty man's a dog named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was a damn old dad from a worn-out picture that my mother had. Knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. My blood ran cold and I said, hey, hey, Sue, how do you do? Oh, cool, but I, well, I hit it hard right between the eyes and they went down, but to my surprise, I'm up with a knife, carved the face of my head. And I busted the chain right across his teeth, and crashed through the walls and in the street, jigging in the gallon, the blood, the blood, the beer. I fought tougher men. I really can't smell the land. Kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. Well, I heard him laugh and I heard him cuss. And he reached for his gun, I pulled mine first. He stood there looking at me and I saw him smile. And he said, son, this world is rough. If a man's gonna make it, you gotta be tough. And I knew I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name, I said goodbye, and I knew you'd have to get tough. Your dad. Oh, is that name to help to make you strong? He said, no, you just want to feel the fight. I know you ain't even got the right. Kill me now, I wouldn't blame you if you knew. But you ought to thank me before I die. Make a double in the gut, stick to right, cause I'm a servant. mentioned I hate that name? Thank you. Thank you very much. Boy, needs to. Can I do one more?
Yeah.
All right. Let me see what else I got.